you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Romans chapter 8, verse 12 says, therefore, brethren, we are debtors not to the flesh to live after the flesh. For if we live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children and heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body. For we are saved by hope, but hope that is seen is not hope. For what a man seeth, why doth he yet hope for? But if we hope for what we see not, then do we with patience wait for it? Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we ought pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is in the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. Hallelujah. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own Son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that he is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that love us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. I just read into your hearing Psalm 91, Psalm 100, excuse me, Proverbs chapter 30, and Romans chapter 8. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. I want to say thank you, Lord, for this is truly the day that you have made, and we shall be thankful and rejoice in it. Father God, I just want to say thank you for, first and foremost, God, for your son, Jesus. We thank you, Father God, for the shed blood on Mount Calvary, that we will one day be in your presence, be in the presence of God Almighty. We thank you, Father God, for all that you are doing, all that you've done. But God, we thank you for what you're about to do. I want to say thank you, Father God, for the forgiveness of all my sins, God, past, present, and future. I want to say thank you, Father God, because you are truly God all by yourself. I want to say thank you, Father God, for forgiving me for all the offenses that I have committed against others, God, intentionally and unintentionally, God. So as I do pray these prayers before you, Lord God, that they will not fall upon deaf ears. I pray, Father God, for the safety, for the deliverance, for the redemption of those who are listening to the sound of my voice and those that are watching us on TV, God. We thank you for each and every one who has continued to support this ministry, God. And I just want to say thank you. And it's in Jesus' name and for his sake I pray and give thanks. Amen. Amen. I just want to welcome everyone once again to the Sword of the Spirit show. I am your host, God's Pitbull, Apostle Dr. Shaolin Abrams. And I just want to say thank you. I really do want to say thank you to all those who have continued to support this ministry. Because I'm telling you what, prayer changes things. You know, they have that, it's a, what is it, push, pray until something happens. So we just want to say thank you. As these holidays are upon us, let us reflect. Let us not wait until we're prouded. You know, like you have a stick and you poke at somebody. Let us not wait until this time before we want to have a giving heart. Let us not wait until this time before we want to start forgiving family, friends, and loved ones who have done us wrong. Let's not just wait until this time before we just start wanting to be helpful. You know what I'm saying? God has given us a command. You know what that command is? Ah, that's good. That command is to love one another. That command is to love your neighbors as yourself. That command is to continue to love those people who have done wrong things against you. That's what that command is. So that's why tonight's lesson, we're going to be talking about the Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. So of all the chapters in the Bible, the Holy Trinity must surely be the Holy of Holies. So sacred and solemn is this subject that is examined reverently and mindful of the scripture admonition that says, then he said, do not draw near to this place. Take your sandals off your feet, for this place where you stand is holy ground. Exodus chapter 3, verse 5. Now the scriptures are God's revelation to himself to man. So God gave the word of God. He gave part of himself through the word to man, okay? Now the scriptures fully reveal his triune Godhead. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. He is co-equal in deity, in presence, in substance, and in attributes. Yet he fulfills different ministries in each office. This manifold revelation of God is everything man needs to prepare for eternity. Scriptural fundamentalists are often called Trinitarians for accepting the scripture doctrine of the Trinity. Now, contrary to the claims of some religious cults, some believers don't worship a three-headed God or three gods. Fundamental to scriptural truth is the true believer's belief in one God. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4. Now the Holy Trinity is an introduction to the character, nature, and the person of God. in the threefold revelation of himself through the ages. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting, you are God. Psalm chapter 90, verse 2. Now, the Holy Spirit, or the let's look at the Holy Trinity. Let's look at God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit as what God reveals about himself in the scriptures, okay? First of all, he declared to be one God. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 44, verse 6, thus says the Lord. So you know when you hear that, that's God speaking. The King of Israel and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last. Besides me, there is no other God. Now, understand the reason why God said that, because he said in his commandments that he's a jealous God and that you shall worship no other God but me. So the worship of other gods is forbidden. The Bible says, and Jesus answered and said to him, get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only you shall serve. Luke chapter 4, verse 8. Number two, God will share his glory with no one. God won't share his glory with anybody. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory I will not give to another, nor my praise to carved images. Isaiah chapter 42, verse 8. Now, the Trinity, there's nowhere in the scriptures that talk about the Trinity, but understand that it's demonstrated as God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Now, the Holy Spirit is demonstrated through God's